I don't think we ever thought we would cure things, but I did sort of naively feel in the beginning that the world was going to be different because of music. What a stupid idea that is. But, you know, there was an awareness with the young, especially, who just changed what was an industry, you know, of popular music. Oh, you write the song, I'll find the song, the guy to sing it, we'll all clean up together. And suddenly somebody that didn't sing in a conventional way, didn't play in the conventional chord changes and stuff, came up with songs that were totally inspirational to me, because I suppose I'd been traveling the same route, and my politics were broadly left wing. I loved the work of Woody Guthrie, and we did kind of stop the war in Vietnam, or possibly the youth, the ones that were being required to go and do the dirty work, were singing about and listening to music that indicated they didn't have to do that, or there might be another way. But unfortunately, music doesn't really change anything, and but it's occupied all my conscious hours and all my life, really. It's not always just the straight message that's important. There's things like the poetic angle of things, rhyme schemes to stick to. Try to be more poetic. Try to find better images. Try to just be satisfied with creating something that didn't exist before.
Perhaps best known for that song that you wrote in the 60s, Streets of London, that rolls off everybody's tongue the minute you say the name Ralph McTell. In fact, I was reading that apart from it going to number 2 on the UK singles charts in 74, it was covered by more than 200 performers, but now it's nearer 2,000 cover versions because of YouTube. How do you feel about
it's
that?
It's extraordinary. It's really extraordinary because, truthfully, you know, I still don't know why it is that one song has... Of course, I'm tremendously grateful, but I still don't know why. Not quite why, because it certainly, the way it's interpreted, is not... It wasn't my motivation. I don't think it was my motivation for writing a song about... I wanted people to feel compassion for those worse off than themselves, but I particularly wanted my friend to stop taking risks with his life and hurting his friends who loved him, who couldn't kind of get in there and stop him doing what he was doing. Mm. But I'm still mystified.
I'm very glad to speak to you, to know that you're still full of beans these days, and in fact your first studio release album in the last 9 years is about to come out. It's called Hill of Beans.
Well, you know, I am a romantic in the sense of the word. I think I found a rather melancholy sort of 40s ballady type tune on the piano to set it all to, and I thought in the end, I think that's a good title because that sort of sums things up.
We're very much looking forward to that album. When does it come out?
Well, I've just been speaking to the great man himself, Tony Visconti, who's producing the album and wrote some of the string parts and played on the album as well. And it's at the mastering stage now. Whether it'll be ready for Australia, it'd be lovely. But, I mean, I think that there's so many songs now and so many albums that I shall probably try and play a couple from this album. But there's so much stuff that I'm looking forward to sharing that... you know, I don't think we'll be short of material.
I'm sure not. Ralph McTell, we really look forward to seeing you again down under. And thank you.
It's been a pleasure. Thanks a lot.
Thank you. Thanks for your time.